We have...
Transform your little girl into a Disney princess. There are some absolutely gigando names in entertainment here, so let's check it out. That was fun!
Here it is, the number 7 must-see at Walt Disney World Resort, the Cirque du Soleil show, La Nuba.
Welcome to the downtown Disney West Side, home of the Cirque du Soleil show, La Nuba. Now, all the Cirque du Soleil shows are different. That's why they have different names. And the La Nuba show is exclusive to the Walt Disney World Resort, so you can't see it anywhere else. No matter what your age, if you're up for a big fat chunk of absolute eye, ear, and imagination candy, then grab some tickets and see the Cirque du Soleil show, La Nuba. To continue our countdown, we hit the recreation world part of Walt Disney World, a world that is home to 4 championship golf courses, 2 of which are the annual host to the PGA Tour Pro. Woo! Did you get that? It's still going, isn't it? No, just kidding. I'll tell you what, I got a hold of that one on the 16th tee. But, believe it or not, this isn't where we find our next must-see. So, grab your safari gear and summon your sense of adventure, because we are about to go wild, Disney style. Jumbo, everybody! I'm your host, Stacy. We have some decisions to make, you and me. The next attraction on our countdown lives in a pretty wild place. Look at those teeth! Disney's Animal Kingdom Park. But this ain't no zoo. In fact, it is far from it. So what is it? Well, it's a little bit of Africa, a little bit of Asia, a little bit of Broadway, and a pinch of prehistoric.
Whoa, look at those chompas.
All with a great big scoop of the imagination of Disney gone wild. I hear drums. This way.
Woo, I got the rhythm.
Which way should we go? So many choices.
It's also where you can dive into the live stage show, finding
Finding Nemo the Musical, a magical mix of original songs, mesmerizing puppetry, and Broadway-style theatrics. Hey, buddy!
So there's nothing alive in here.
Nothing alive. That's
okay. Oh! Just kidding. Scared you. Come on, let's go!
Disney on stage, then head back to Camp Minnie Mickey, home of Festival of the Lion King, a fantastic theatrical celebration inspired by the animated Disney hit. There's nothing like singing and dancing with Simba and the gang. And don't forget, Camp Minnie Mickey is a great spot for catching up with the characters, too.
Turn around, I have to see all of you.
I have a crush on Mickey.
So you want to go for some wild rides? Well, Disney's Animal Kingdom's got what you need.
And the other the spin cycle. So if you'll excuse me, I'm about to get my ride on at Disney's Animal Kingdom. A little Kali River Rapids and Primeval World combo. Let's ride. We have to go all the way to Africa. Well, Disney's Africa.
Chomp, chomp.
And it's a lot like going to the real Africa, but without all the malaria shots and stuff. So, get your cameras ready and keep your eyes open.
The number 6 Walt Disney World must-see
is Kilimanjaro Safari.
Woo! We're four-wheeling now, baby.
Just through the African village of Harambe is an actual living, breathing African savanna. I love the dress. It's home to lions, crocs, giraffes, elephants, hippos, cheetahs, and all other kinds of wild creatures that you'll see as you ramble through on your safari vehicle. I see giraffes over there. It's Disney's Mother Africa right here in Florida that puts Kilimanjaro Safaris on our list for the top 7 must-sees at Walt Disney World.
Don't go away. When we come back, the number 5 must-see at Walt Disney World Resort.
There's a lot of ways to see Walt Disney World Resort, so let's talk tickets. The big news is how easy Disney has made it to do the things you want. It's a little thing called Magic Your Way Ticket, which lets you choose the options you want. So if you want to do just one theme park each day, no sweat, you can do that. If you want to go from theme park on the same day, you got it. Just add the park hopper option. Think you might want to do all that great stuff outside the theme parks too? Add the water park fun and more option, which hooks you up with theme park admission, the Disney water parks, Disney Quest Indoor Interactive Theme Park, Disney's Wide World of Sports Complex, or Disney's Oak Trail Golf Course. Just purchase your tickets in the lobby. Our friendly cast members can even upgrade your Magic Your Way tickets to add days or include these options on the spot or at any time during your stay.
Welcome back, everybody! If you're ready to see what's next on our countdown, then grab your bathing suit! Let me just fix my suit! Grab your sunscreen and as much of your guts and glory as you can stuff into a beach bag, and let's hit the Disney water parks!
To 2 water parks that are literally drenched in Disney imagination. The polar opposite of other water parks is Disney's Blizzard Beach. If you like water slides, welcome to the center of the water slide universe. I'm on the top of the world! I am talking about water slides at the wazoo. Let's ride. happy.
Attraction. So get your booty over there to see Captain Jack. And as part part of the Year of a Million Dreams, you can live your dreams through immersive entertainment, where suddenly you're not watching a parade, you are the parade. You not only see a princess, you become one, or a pirate. It's make-believe made real, and it's happening all around you every day. You know, when most people think of the Magic Kingdom Park, they think of classic Disney experiences. I'm gonna ride that puppy! And while that is true, there are some great additions here.
Like Buzz Lightyear's Space Ranger Spin, inspired by Disney Pixar's Toy Story 2. And make sure you swing by the castle stage for an amazing dream-inspired stage spectacular called Dream Along with Mickey, starring Mickey and just about the whole gang in a fabulous celebration of the dreams we all have in our hearts.
Wow! But what's next on our countdown is a classic Disney triple crown. Or should I say triple mountain whammy?
Check it out! The number 4 Walt Disney World must-see.
Here we go! Space Mountain, Splash Mountain, and Big Thunder Mountain. And lucky me, I'm gonna hit them all. Triple Mountain Whammy.
That was so great.
Big Thunder Mountain. Wham, wham, wham. Splash Mountain. It's all wham. Now, don't go running out of Magic Kingdom just yet. Because when the sun sets, something pretty amazing happens. The sky comes alive to a little thing called wishes. Wishes is one of the baddest, biggest, most fantastic, eye-popping, mind-blowing Big Daddy fireworks show in Disney history. And it's the ultimate end to any Disney day. Those fireworks were the most amazing thing. This story in the sky is one of the best blasts of Disney magic to date.
We now return to the top 7 must-sees at Walt Disney World Resort.
Like that? Welcome back to the top 7 must-sees at Walt Disney World, everybody. I'm Stacy, and to reveal the next attraction on our countdown, we are here at the place where Hollywood shows off its Tinseltown best. From TV to movies, to music and theater, Disney's Hollywood Studios. Studios is a great place to catch a kid-friendly classic, like Playhouse Disney live on stage. Yeah! Or the incredible nighttime spectacular Fantasmic, where Sorcerer Mickey battles it out with the evil villains of Disney past. And brand new to Disney's Hollywood Studios is Toy Story Mania. A new 4D attraction inspired by Disney Pixar's Toy Story films. Here's what you do. Throw on some super 3D glasses, zip off into a sweet Toy Story world full of immersive Midway-style games, and blast away with your super snazzy spring action shooter to launch virtual darts, rings, eggs, pies, and more. Trust me, you're gonna wanna ride this one over and over. Join in the fun as Block Party Bash makes its way through Disney's Hollywood Studios. Familiar faces from Disney Pixar films are partying in the street. If you love Disney Pixar movies and you love to play, you won't want to miss this chance to have some fun with the stars of some of your favorite films. We're gonna go find some characters! You have very nice penmanship, Donald. I love Goofy. Hi, what big eyes you have.
Hello, Incredibles.
Yes, I feel incredible. Indiana Jones. He's cute. You know, while you're at the studios, you are just a stone's throw away from a couple of the biggest thrills this side of Neverland.
So come with me. We're going to go check them out.
This is the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror.
It takes you 13 stories up and then drops you faster than the speed of gravity. And to make things even worse, this thing now serves up random ride sequences so you never know what you're gonna get. And this baby's called the Rock and Roller Coaster starring Aerosmith. In the name of all that rocks, it's hit it, dude. The launch alone is a thrill ride in itself. 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds. Rock, baby. Love roller coasters. Love Aerosmith. Hello. Ladies and gentlemen, because next on our countdown is an attraction raced in from Disneyland Paris.
Get ready. Here's the number 3 must-see attraction at Walt Disney World Resort.
Lights, motors, action, extreme sunshine. The precision driving was awesome. Now you can forget about the edge of your seat. This thing is so high octane that it doesn't even have a seat. It's cars nearly missing, motorcycles jumping in your face.
When we come back, the number 2 must-see at Walt Disney World Resort.
Here's a tip I'm sure you're gonna love. Extra magic hours benefit. Sounds pretty cool, right? But what is it? It's extra hours of magic. Each day, one of the theme parks opens an hour early or stays open up to 3 hours after regular closing time. It's a great time to visit with favorite characters or to ride some of the most popular attractions.
Oh, and bonus! The water parks also have extra magic hours available.
Make sure to check with your lobby concierge to find out the details each day and go get you some extra magic. Hey, Mickey, where are you, buddy?
We now return to the top 7 must-sees at Walt Disney World Resort.
Welcome back to the top 7 must-sees at Walt Disney World Resort, everybody. To continue our countdown, we are at Epcot. This is beautiful!
That's fun.
Epcot is the proud owner of some flat-out incredible attractions that flat-out kick... I love the fish. Fish, fish, fish. Everywhere fish. Don't forget to swing into the seas with Nemo and friends.
Hop on board a clammobile for an undersea adventure inspired by Disney Pixar's Finding Nemo.
Marlin, he's here. Dory, she's here too. And guess who they're trying to find? And while you're here, stop by and see Crush, because he stars in his own interactive show at the seas with Nemo and friends called Turtle Talk with Crush. Hey, Crush!
What's up, Daisy?
It's a live animated show.
I totally know what you're talking about, man.
It's amazing.
Later, Dean.
Another pretty amazing thing you've got to check out while you're at Epcot is Illuminations, Reflections of Earth. Every night, a symphony of sound, light, and fireworks choreographs an amazing close to your day at Epcot. Epcot is great for mixing things up. I mean, think about all the great stuff I've shown you so far, right? And now check this out. Test Track, baby. It's a get-in, strap-in, let-it-rip ride that puts you in a test park, runs it through its paces on one of the longest, fastest rides of Walt Disney World. Let's hit it. This is me on Test Park. It was pedal to the metal. So you just tore it up on Test Track. So what do you do next? Well, you're at Epcot, so you go around the world. Oh, she is.
Without actually going around the world, I'm talking about World Showcase. And not only are all the great countries, people, and food from around the world here, Italy, China, France, Japan, Germany, yummy, 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 yummy. The gelato guy in Italy?
Chocolate.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Yummy. But the beauty is it takes just 5 minutes or so to go from, like, Japan to Italy. So, let's go do a little World Showcase. Hello, Norway. Pretzels und Bier. Konnichiwa. Wish. What's next on our countdown is what I like to call a flying high combo. That launch was the real deal. First, an exhilarating hang glider flight over planet Earth. Then a little white knuckle throw ride to the red planet.
It's time for the number two must see at Walt Disney World Resort.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Soarin' and Mission Space. Let's fly. Should be fine.
Don't go away. When we come back, the number one must see at Walt Disney World Resort.
This is the year of a million dreams, and you're here for it. How cool is that? I'll tell you how cool it is. Throughout the celebration, over a million extra special dreams, some even thought impossible, are being awarded to eligible guests and mail-in participants through a random process in the 2008 Disney Dreams Giveaway. And when you walk into any of the Walt Disney World theme parks or downtown Disney area, guess what? You could be awarded a dream. Eligible guests are being awarded amazing prizes at the Walt Disney World Resort. Imagine a one-night stay in a magical suite in Cinderella Castle. Yep, Cinderella Castle. Or how about a Dream Fast Pass badge? Good the entire day it's awarded to enjoy some of the most popular Disney attractions with little to no wait time in line. Or wham, you could get hit with a $500 shopping spree to use that day. To find out more about the 2008 Disney Dreams Giveaway, visit guest relations at any Walt Disney World Resort theme park, water park, or at the downtown Disney area. Or visit disneyparks.com/2008rules.
We now return to the top seven must-sees at Walt Disney World Resort.
Welcome back. Okay, this is it. The end of our countdown. It is time to reveal the number one must-see attraction at Walt Disney World Resort. A colossal adventure looming on the horizon of Asia at Disney's Animal Kingdom. It's like they took the Himalayas and dropped them in Florida. Expedition Everest.
This is it. The number one must-see attraction at Walt Disney World Resort.
So, here's the deal. You're hopping a high-speed train through the Himalayas on your way to Mount Everest, right? Everything's hunky-dory until you start picking up speed and banking tight corners. Oh, and then there's the whole Guardian of the Mountain thing. Yeah, the Yeti, the abominable snowman. That thing is huge. He's not too thrilled to see you, so he freaks out. Then you freak out because he looks hungry. Then the train freaks out. It starts going backwards. It was like all of a sudden, boom, the lights are gone. It's cold. It's dark. Let's do it. Come on.
use our local Doppler radar. Tonight, clear to partly cloudy, low 50, winds light and variable. And on Monday, partly cloudy early, followed by mostly cloudy skies and a few showers later in the day. High 76, chance of rain 30%. And Monday night, skies clearing overnight, low 55, winds light and variable. The week ahead.
Thank you.
Tuesday, partly cloudy, slight chance of a rain shower, high 75. Here's our 7-day outlook.